Hello, my name is Amy Sturkey. I am a pediatric physical therapist, and I am going to teach how you measure ankle range of motion. I have a handsome boy, Sammy, who's willing to donate his feet. He gets to keep them when we're done. And we're just going to measure his ankles. I'm going to use a goniometer, so I'll show you how it's done. All right, so what I do is I get this line, even with the bone that goes along here, the tibia, and I have this line along the edge of the foot, right up through here. So what you should have is normally 15 to 20. So that's neutral right there. And then that's 5, that's 10, that's 15, and that is 20 degrees. So he has normal, what's dorsiflexion range of motion. That's where your foot goes up. Now, the other direction where your foot goes down, that's called plantar flexion. So there's neutral. You should have 45 degrees. So let's see how far this foot goes down. Whoop. That's 10, 20, 30. And it looks like I'm starting to get more 4-foot plantar flexion. Oh, he says he can go further. Thank you. You got more? There you go. There you go. So there it is, 45. So it's 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 35, 40, 45 degrees plantar flexion. Perfect. You might not have one of these handy dandy things, so I'm going to show you how to do it with an app. It's not quite as accurate, but it is a way you can do it. So next I'm going to show you how I measure it with an iPhone. I use the clinometer app, C-L-I-N-O-M-E-T-E-R. And it's an iPhone app or Android-based phone app. And what you have to do is start making sure that your lower leg is totally parallel to the ground to be able to get a good measure. So sometimes that means I have to prop up, if they have a big calf, I have to prop up the ankle just a little bit. That's about as good as I'm going to get. And then I get the foot into neutral, so it's pointing straight up toward the sky, and I start off with it at about 0 degrees right there. And then if I just keep it in contact with it, so it says 0 right now, I see how far that foot can go up. And we can see we got 15, 18, 19, 20. So 15 to 20 degrees is normal. And you can see with this, by keeping it flush against his leg, I can see how far that can go. Similarly, I can see how far he goes down in plantar flexion. So let me get centered again. I've got it right there centered on his leg, straight up and down. And I can go down to see how far he can get into plantar flexion. Help me go down, sweetie. And looks like he can get down to 46 degrees as well. Again, this is not as exact as a goniometer, but it's certainly a functional way if you have no goniometer, but you have a smartphone, to be able to measure how much range of motion your child has. Normal passive range of motion is 15 to 20 up and 45 degree down. Sammy, can you pull up your foot totally by yourself? Up, 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 up. Go up, I'm sorry. See how far your foot can go up by itself. So you're gonna go like that, okay? All right, let me get started again because I was not ready. So let me get centered on here. Straight up and down. All right, pull up your foot for me. Go up as far as you can. So it looks like active, he's got about 15 degrees as opposed to when I pushed on him, he had 20. And let's see how far, when you push down, Sammy, your foot can go down. And he's got, it's saying 47 degrees if I measure it with a clinometer, which is pretty good. I hope this was helpful so you could compare how I use the goniometer in the clinic and how you might be able to use the clinometer app on your phone to be able to measure ankle range of motion. That way you can see at home if your child or you have ankle range of motion restrictions. I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye. If you liked this video and would like to be notified by email when the next video comes out, click the subscribe button here and click the golden bell icon and ensure notifications are enabled on your account.